विष्णुपादाय कृष्णपृष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती नामिने भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती ठाकुर एक पास्ट अवे फ्रॉम दिस मटेरियल वर्ल्ड ऑन 31st December 1936. So, almost 40 years passed. So there are two phases, prakat and aprakat, appearance and disappearance. So we have nothing to lament on account of disappearance, because Krishna and Krishna's devotees, not only devotees, even the non-devotees, nobody disappears. Nobody disappears because every living entity, as Krishna is eternal, it is confirmed in the Vedic literature, nitya nityana, chetana chetanana. The description of the Supreme Lord is that He is also nitya eternal, and the living entities are also eternal, but He is the chief eternal. Nitya nityanam chetana chetanai. So qualitatively there is no difference between Krishna and the living entities. And quantitatively there is difference. What is the difference between nitya, the similar number nitya, and the plural number nitya? The plural number nitya is subordinate, eternal servants of the singular number nitya. Just like if you want to serve somebody, so the master is also exactly like you. He has got two hands, two legs, or the same sentiments, he also eats. Everything is same there. But the difference is the master and the servant, that's all. Otherwise, equal in every respect. So spiritually, appearance and disappearance, there is no difference. Just like in material point of view, if a person takes birth, suppose you get a son born, you become very happy. The same son, when passes away, you become very unhappy. This is material. And spiritually, there is no such difference, appearance or disappearance. So although this is the disappearance day of Om Vishwas, Sushumad Bhakti Siddhanta Sarasvati Thakur, so there is nothing to be lament. Although we feel separation, that feeling is there, but spiritually there is no difference between appearance and disappearance. There is a song, Narottam Das Thakur's song, Jyanila Premodhano. Do you know anyone of you? Can you sing that song, anyone? Jyanila Premodhana Karuna Prachur Eno Prabhu Kothagala. I don't remember exactly the whole song. That is our lamentation. That's Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur brought this message to distribute all over. Of course, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu expressed his desire that Prithivite Ache Jato Nagaradi Gram sarvatra prachara haive vardha. He predicted that all over the world, as many towns and villages are there, everywhere, my name will be known. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's name, which is now attempted now, it is being actually. To execute this will of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he said personally, Bharat Bhumite Manusya Janma Hoila Jat, Janma Sarthakari Karo Paropkar. He wanted that his name should be broadcast all over the world, in every town, every village. And who would do it? That he asked, that anyone who has taken birth in Bharatvarsha, India, it is his duty, first of all, make himself perfect by understanding the philosophy of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, then broadcast it, distribute it. This was the duty of every Indian. The Indian, especially in India, they have got the privilege to take advantage of the Vedic literature. In other countries, there is no such advantage. So, if anyone wants to make his life perfect, then he has to take advantage of the vast treasure house of Indian spiritual knowledge. Even one Chinese gentleman, he has written one book about religion that is a course in New York University. So he has said that if you want to know something of religion, then you have to go to India. That's a fact. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said that every Indian, there is a need of broadcasting this Krishna consciousness movement all over the world. So it is the duty of every Indian to first of all make his life perfect. He must know. Perfection means he must know what is his position and what he has to do. That is perfection. At the present moment, people do not know what he is, even whether he is this body or something extra. The big scientists, they are also paleo. This is perfection. First of all, one must know what he is, whether he is this body or something beyond this body. This is the beginning of spiritual knowledge. So that advantage is there in India by culture, by education. Therefore, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu requested that Indians, Bharatiya, Bharatvarsha, those who have taken birth as human being, he doesn't speak to the animals. Bharat Bhumite Manushajan. Manushajan means human. Because without being human being, nobody can understand these things. The cats and dogs, they cannot understand. So a person whose behavior is like cats and dogs, he also cannot understand. Therefore he said, Janma Sarthakari. First of all, make your life perfect and then distribute this knowledge. This is the Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mission. So he simply said, but he was expecting that in later days his followers would do that. So that attempt was made by Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur. Bhakti Vinod Thakur, he deserved, and that Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's message is to be accepted by East and West equally, and both the Indians and the Europeans, Americans, they should dance together in ecstasy of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mercy. That was his desire. Bhaktivinoda Thakur. He simply expressed the desire, when I shall see this happening, that both the Eastern and Western people, they are united on the basis of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's cult and dancing together in ecstasy. That was his ambition. This was ambition of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and this was the ambition of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. And Sri Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur took up this affair, business, and he wanted, first of all. So, every student, any disciple, every disciple, especially those who are competent, he requested that you take up this mission of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and preach in the Western country. That was Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur first attempt. Before that, even the acharyas, Rupanuga, Goswamis, they left literature, but they did not attain to preach practically. And Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur, he was very, very anxious to preach this Chaitanya cult in the Western countries. That is, see, Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur's special contribution. So, when I met Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur, it is a long story how I met him, one of my friends, he dragged me. I was at that time a nationalist and manager in a big chemical factory. My age was about 24 years. So one of my friends, he asked me, there is a nice sadhu, Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur, he has come in Calcutta. So let us go and see. So I was reluctant. I thought, just like, so there are so many sadhus. So I am not very much, because I had very bad experience. Not very good. So I said, this kind of sadhus, there are many. You'll be glad to know that in young age or early age, it was Krishna's grace, even amongst my young friends, I was considered the leader. In my school days, in my college days, in my private friendship, somehow or other, I became their leader. And one astrologer, sometimes he read my hands, he said in Hindi, hukum chalega. Hukum chalega means your hand speaks, that your order will be executed. So anyway, it was Krishna's said, I would not go, but their point of view was that unless I sacrifice that sadhu, Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur, he will not be accepted. Therefore he dragged me. So I went to see Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur on that day. On the first meeting, just we offer our obeisances, it is the practice. So, immediately began his talking that You are all educated young men. Why didn't you take us, see Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's cult and preach all over the English lying public? Why didn't you take up this matter? So I argued with him in some way. At that time I was nationalist. So I told that who will accept our message? We are dependent nation. Nobody will care. In this way, in my own way, in this younger days. But we belong to the Vaishnava family. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Nityananda, Radha Govinda. That is our worshipful duty, worshipful deity. So, I was very glad that Radha Krishna cult, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, this sadhu is trying to preach. It is very nice. So, at that time we had some talks, and of course I was defeated by his argument, my argument. And then, when he came out, we are offered prasadam, very nice treatment, the Gauri amount. And when I came out on the street, this my friend asked me, what is your opinion of this sadhu? Then I said that here is the right person who has taken out Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's message and now it will be distributed. So I was at that time a fool, but I opined like this and I accepted him as my spiritual master immediately. Not officially, but in my heart. That was in 1922. Then, in 1923, I left Calcutta on my business too. And I made my headquarters at Allahabad. Allahabad is about 500 miles from Calcutta. So I was thinking that I met a very nice, saintly person. That was my thinking, always. So in this way, in 1928, there was a Kumbh Mela. At that time, these Gauri Math people came to Allahabad to establish a center there, and somebody informed them that you go to that Prayag Pharmacy, my drug shop was named as Prayag Pharmacy, my name was also there, you go and see Abhay Babu, he is religiously, he will help you. These Gauri Math people, they came to me. So, sir, we have come to you, we have heard your good name, so we want to start a temple here. Please try to help us. Because I was thinking of these Gauri Math people that I met, very nice, simple people. As soon as I saw them, I was very much embarrassed. Oh, here are these persons, they have come again. So in this way, gradually, I became attached to these Gauri Math activities. And by the grace of Krishna, my business also was not going very well. Krishna says, Jasahun Amigridani Hariseta Dhanamsani. If somebody wants to be actually devotee of Krishna, at the same time keeps his material attachment, then Krishna's business is he takes away everything material so that same person he becomes. I am to say, dependent on Krishna. So So that actually happened to my life. I was obliged to come to this movement to take up this very seriously. And I was dreaming that Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur is calling me, please come out with me. So I was sometimes horrified. What is this? I have to give up my family life. Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur is calling me. I have to take sannyas. Oh, I was horrified. But I saw similar time calling me. So anyway, it is by His grace I was forced to give up my family life and so-called business life. And He brought me somewhere or other in preaching His gospel. So this is a memorable day. What you deserve. I am trying little bit and you are all helping me. So I have to thank you more. You are actually representative of my Guru Maharaj. Because you are helping me in executing the order of my Guru Maharaj. Thank you very much.
श्री राधा कृष्ण भोग बिना साहब गुण राधा कृष्ण गुरी वर्धन की जय नाम धाम की जय मंदिर धाम की जय गंगा माई की जय यमुना माई की जय तुलसी देवी की जय भक्ति देवी की जय स्वामी तो भक्त बिंदु की जय और ग्लोरी और ग्लोरी और ग्लोरी थैंक यू वेरी मच All these garlands may the bush come, who has come? Garland.
Most revered Prabhupada, my brethren and sisters of ISKCON and devotees. It's not merely an act of formality that I rise to speak on this occasion, the appearance day of Srila Prabhupada. It's a day of great importance to me as well as to everybody else who has come here today to celebrate this function. I do not know how to explain the importance of this day. Should I say that on this day was laid the very foundation of the beautiful mansion of ISKCON which Prabhupada is building and which promises to be the Taj, so to say, of the spiritual world, the greatest wonder of the spiritual world. Should I say that on this day fell a seed from the spiritual tree of Krishna Prem, which was sown by Madhavendra Puri and of which the trunk was Sriman Mahaprabhu and the branches were Advaita, Advaitacharya, Nityananda Prabhu, Rup Sanatana and others. A seed fell from this tree on this day in the form of Srila Prabhupada Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Maharaj. It is sprouted in the form of Gaudiya Mission. And it's now growing in the form of ISKCON. And I hope it will continue to grow till the prophecy of Mahaprabhu is fulfilled. The prophecy, the teachings of Mahaprabhu will be carried to every nook and corner of the world. But I should like to express the importance of this day in a different way, which is more dear to me. I should like to say that on this day was born a great spiritual scientist, a great spiritual alchemist, who worked wonders with the science of spiritual alchemy. You know, the science of alchemy changes baser metals into gold and silver. Now, this spiritual alchemist had the wonderful power of changing baser men into superior men, of changing sinners into saints, of changing non-believers into believers, non-Vaishnavas into Vaishnavas. And when I say this, I speak from my personal experience. Should I tell you that I was a very different man some 45 years ago? I was a rank, I shouldn't say non-believer, but I was a rank Mayavadi, a firm believer in the doctrine of Advaitism. As a student of philosophy and as a favorite student of Professor Ranade, the head of the philosophy department of the Allahabad University, I had come to believe that there was no philosophy on the face of earth higher than the philosophy of Advaitism, the philosophy of Mayavad. And there was no end superior to the end of the attainment of Nirvikalpa Samadhi, in which one realizes one's complete identity with Brahma.
This was my firm belief, and it was impossible for anyone to dislodge me from it. But you know, and you will not believe what happened one day when I first met my Prabhupada, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Maharaj, at Allahabad, at the house of one Mr. Day, sometime in the month of August 1931. As I went to see him, he stared into my eyes, seemed to be looking deep into me, and it appeared that he had discovered something. You know what he had discovered? He had discovered the ghost in me, the ghost of Mayavad, which had possessed me. And at once, you see, he started his alchemy. He delivered a long and passionate discourse, which continued for about an hour and a half. I listened to him as spellbound. It was magic. How charmed. As the words were coming from his mouth, I felt that they were striking the innermost, penetrating the innermost recesses of my heart and were working a wonderful change in me. There was a strange ring in his words. There was a magic in it. The words seemed to be rousing me from my dogmatic slumber of Mayavad. I seemed to wake up and see a new light. There was a great commotion in me. You see, all my old beliefs seemed to be dashed into pieces. The strongest arguments on which the edifice Mayavad is raised seem to have been cut into pieces by the sharp arguments of Prabhupada. And it appeared to me that the edifice of Mayavad, which stood magnificently in my heart, was crumbling. Pillar after pillar was falling. And I saw that in very little time it was reduced into ashes. There was, I said, a great commotion in me. There was a storm. Old beliefs and new. A tussle went on. And this went on for a very long time. It went on for about a year. And during this period, I followed Prabhupada wherever he went. I went with him from Allahabad to Benares, from Benares to Calcutta, from Calcutta to Darjeeling, from Darjeeling back to Calcutta, and then to Allahabad, and then finally I came along with him here to Vrindavan. That's the soul which had been going in my mind, that storm which was raging, had to subside. It did subside. And peace and calm was restored in my mind. But the peace that was restored, the calm that was restored, was not the calm of Mayavad, the still and barren calm of Mayavad, but the delightful and blissful calm of Bhakti. I was now a changed man. I was inclined to Bhakti. I was inclined towards Vaishnavism. And so, one day in Radha Kundal, perhaps in Nimasan Pratik, on the day of Purnamasi, I was duly initiated by Sri Ramakrishna. So I say that this day is a great day of great importance for me, because it has completely changed my life. I was just an insect of the train. Prabhupada picked me up and made me a different man altogether. Now, Prabhupada is no more. But should I say that Prabhupada is no more? When Prabhupada, Bhaktivedanta Maharaj with us, I believe that Prabhupada is functioning through him. He is also a great alchemist. He is also working wonders. What my Prabhupada did to me, he is doing to millions and millions of people all the world over. And it will not be any exaggeration if I say that the indomitable spirit with which he is working, the crown of success which he wears, leave no doubt that Srila Prabhupada Bhaktivedanta Maharaj is the true successor of Prabhupada Bhaktivedanta Saraswati Goswami Maharaj. So that we may say, on this day of the appearance of Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Maharaj, that although Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Maharaj has disappeared, he lives in Prabhupada. And so, Prabhupada has disappeared, and yet he is alive and active and long, long
So, ladies and gentlemen, this is my spiritual master's appearance anniversary day. So, as Dr. Kapoor has explained to you, that Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur changed his life. Similarly, my life was also changed.
by these great saintly persons. I was inclined to nationalist movement, follower of Mahatma Gandhi. So in 1922, at that time I was manager in Dr. Joseph's laboratory. I was a young man, and just 3 or 4 years before I was married, and I got a son also. But one my friend, Mr. Mallik, is no more existing. He informed me that one sadhu has come to Calcutta, Gauriya Mahasadhu. So, would you like to see? At that time I was nationalist and I had no very good experience. Then I denied all access to it. What is the use of going there? Wasting time. But he insisted and took me to Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati. And immediately after seeing us, he changed my life. He immediately said that you are all educated young men, why don't you preach the cult of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in the Western world? Right. We hear your cult of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, you are an independent nation, and we hear. First of all, you must have independence, because I was inclined to independence movement. I left my educational career in 1920, joined this movement. So he argued and he defeated me. And there was long talk. Then after coming down on the street, my friend Mr. Mallik asked me, what do you think of this sadhu? So I appreciated, I said, yes, now Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's cult is in the hands of an able personality. Now it will be spread all over the world. Then I was transferred from Calcutta to Allahabad on business concern. But I was always thinking of this sadhu. I am giving a short history, but my life was changed. Of course, I was born in a Vaishnava family. Chaitanya cult was my life and soul. But due to education and bad association, all the modern association, I was declined. Now, this Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakura again revived my consciousness. In this way, in 1933, I became regularly a disciple of Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur. And then in 1936, before his passing away, I wrote one letter to my Guru Maharaj that you have got many disciples, they are giving you direct service, they are very fortunate, but I am a grihastha. I could not do anything for you. So if you kindly order me something to do, then I can try for you. So again he said the same thing, that whatever you have learned from us, try to preach in English. Then I started this Back to Godhead back in 1944, on this very birthday. Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur. And I was looking forward for the opportunity how to implement this order of my Guru Maharaj. Then in 1965, before that, I was translating Bhagavatam. And when 3 books were published, then I prepared myself to go to America single-handed, not for getting any material reputation, but simply to try, because I knew my Guru Maharaj was very, very anxious to preach this cult. So when I saw that there were other my big god brothers, I cannot say that they could not do anything, at least there was no any tangible result. Then in at the age of 70 years, I thought, let me try if I can do something. So I left India in 1965 and went to New York thinking, what shall I do? I do not know what for Krishna has brought me in this place without any friend, without any money. I had only 40 rupees with me and a return ticket in this India Navigation Company. So, for 2-3 months, 6 months, there was no response. I was simply maintaining myself by selling my books. But these young boys, American boys, gradually, they joined me in 1966. I was chanting in a park. What is that, donkeys and a smell? Yeah. And these boys, gradually, they came and joined and danced with me. Then, the New York Times, they published, first of all, I think, our Brahmananda Bruce and our Ochyutananda. What is it, Bernard?
George.
Yes. They were dancing first, hand to hand. Then this news was spread very nicely. One paper voice, they mentioned that we understood that God is dead, but now I see, the reporter said, that Swami Bhaktivedanta has brought back God in his Sankirtan. This was remark. Then gradually we developed, and next branch was established in San Francisco, first in New York, then in Canada, Montreal, Boston. Here is one, my student, old student is present, Satsarup Maharaj. This boy was very enthusiastic from the very beginning. So, by the grace of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and my Guru Maharaj, His Divine Grace, Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur, we have made a ground at least. We have got now 100 branches all over the world, and especially in Europe and America, Australia, and Japan, everywhere. From Scandinavia down to Melbourne, south, north and south, and all over the world. So, these boys are now present here. They have learned how to chant, how to dance, how to offer arati to the deity. We have got Radha Krishna, Jagannath Deity in all our attempts, besides Guru Gauranga. So it was the desire of Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur. So, although my kind god brothers like Dr. Kopur, he said that I am doing wonderful. Actually, I do not know any magic art to do this wonderful, but just I am trying to follow the footsteps of my Guru. But in the Shastras we say, we see that Jasadevi Paravati Jathadevi Tathaguru Tasvaiti Kutita Jatta Pratasamte Mahatma. So I can speak to you frankly that I am so ashamed, except that I wanted to please my Guru Mahatma. That little strength, whatever success and God, it is due to His blessing. Similarly, the Shastra is also there. If we follow actually the order as it is described by Vishwanatha Kurti Thakur, So the order of Guru Maharaj is my life and soul, jiva, he has mentioned. So in this way, we try to follow our Acharya, bona fide Acharya, evam parampara praham mam rajasayantu. Then, to have bona fide Acharya means life is that simply you have to follow. So, today, this auspicious day, my disciples, I request you that I am glad to follow. And you also try to follow, there is great responsibility in your hand because you have to preach. I am now old man of 78 years. I do not expect to live many years more. But you simply follow the footsteps of the Tadero Charana Shiva Bhakta Sanyata. Tadero Charana Shiva Bhakta Sanyata Jana Me Jana Me. This is the secret of the world. You have to follow the Goswami. Enchai Gosai Dar Dharamida. You have to follow this principle. Enchai Gosai Dar Dharamida. Rupanuta Grutta Abhasiddhanta Dhanta Hari. Enchai Rup Sanatana Goswami. If we desire to serve them, they are the Sri Chaitanya Mano Vishvasthapaka, these Goswamis. The Vrindavan Dham is discovered by the Goswamis. Don't deviate from the instruction. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Natkandas Thakur said, Rupa Raghunatha Pade Hoi Virakuti, Kabe Hama Bhujavase Jugalabhati. We should hanker after to understand. What is that jugal ability? Don't jump over that have understood Radha Krishna prayer. No, it is not so easy. Radha Krishna prayer to understand Radha Krishna pranayavati alladini shakti rasuna. This is not ordinary affair. A dealing of a young boy and a young girl. It is the expansion of the alladini shakti of Sri Krishna. So in this way, in Vrindavan, if we want to understand, then Tadera Charana Sevi Bhakta Sanepa Janame Janame Bhavati. This will be the motto of life. Thank you very much.
Shri Prabhupada Jai. Thank you everyone for listening. Very kindly. We now have Press Adam downstairs serving the restaurant.
Thank you. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna.